Okay, let's get started. This starts to be a little confusing, doesn't it? Not? It's all okay? Let me give you the same example with angle of attack. Maybe it will be, it's kind of repeating the same thing, but maybe it will be a good exercise. Now let's look at this. Let's look at an airplane that flies at this velocity. Let's say this is the velocity vector of the airplane. Okay, with respect to someone looking from Earth. Okay? And this is the body fixed coordinate system here. And this is the X body. Okay? And let's say beta is equal to 0. And let's say this thing has two components now. One is like this, and one is like that. Okay, let's call this U, and let's call this one W. And V is equal to 0 because beta is equal to 0. So let's actually maybe give numbers. Okay, so you have U, 0, and W. And this is your alpha here. That's your alpha. Angle of attack. All right? So, this is the velocity of the airplane with respect to someone looking from Earth. This means with respect to Earth fixed frame. And let's give some numbers. Let's make it 800, 0, 50 kilometers per hour. Okay, so there's a 50 component here, 800 here, and what is the full velocity, the velocity of the airplane? You know, it's simply this, 800 square plus 50 square, so that is the velocity of the airplane. Okay, so if there's no wind, okay, there's no wind, you could actually say V infinity is in this direction too. This is V infinity. So if there's no wind, you could actually say is equal to this. It's in the same and it's in the opposite direction. Can you find alpha from this picture? Tangent alpha is equal to W divided by U. So therefore, alpha is equal to inverse W is 50 and U is 800, then you could find alpha from this information. All find this so far? What you here you need to understand is that this velocity V infinity and this velocity vector, which is the velocity of the airplane with respect to an observer on Earth, are not the same velocities. They are different, but in this case they turn out to be the same. This is the velocity of the air particles moving towards the airplane, and this is the velocity of the airplane with respect to an observer on Earth. In this picture, because there is no wind, still atmosphere, they turn out to be the same, that's it. Just in the opposite direction, of course. They don't have to be the same. You understand that part? You understand the difference between this and this? V infinity are the, is the velocity of the air particles moving towards the airplane. VE is the velocity of the airplane with respect to an observing Earth. If the atmosphere is still, they turn out to be the same magnitude but in opposite directions. Because if the atmosphere is still, I'm moving towards the air and the same air is moving towards me, so it will be exactly the same but in opposite directions. Okay? And if this is the story, then this is tangent alpha, blah, 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 this. Okay? Now, take the same picture, okay, take the same picture and do the following. Let's do this. Take the same picture and say now, that there is some air blowing from the bottom up, like an upwind, okay? And that's a wind now. This is a wind, okay? Blowing from below to up, like an upwind, okay? That happens sometimes. The wind just goes from the bottom, goes up. So, and the airplane, assume, still moves in the same direction, nothing has changed. I mean, although there's a wind, it doesn't care, it just goes with this VE. What happened to V infinity? Will it remain the same? No, because the air particles will be this plus the wind now, right? If the airplane is just moving as it was before with respect to this person, will this vector change, the velocity vector of the airplane with respect to that person, if it's just going as it is? No move. It will be the same, right? It's just moving the same way because of this wind. The airplane doesn't seem to be affected. It's just moving the same way. Okay? So this velocity vector is the same with respect to the sky. The airplane is moving as it was moving before. However, there's a wind. Did V infinity change now? Yes. So in this case, I can't say this anymore. Oh, sorry. I can't say this anymore. Right? Because there's a wind now. The V infinity is not this anymore. The infinity, the new V infinity is actually this. The previous V infinity. Okay, let's call it V prime, the previous one. Okay? Plus this one there, this upwind. Right? It will be this plus this. So this is the previous V infinity, which was, in fact, the opposite of this one, plus this new upwind, this one here. So you take this parallel thing, you make a parallelogram, and your new V infinity will be this. This is your new V infinity. That is your new V infinity now. Because you have the wind plus the previous V infinity, which used to be equal to VE, and this is your V infinity now. So the new V infinity is something like that. So did the upwind increase the angle of attack or reduce the angle of attack? It increased it, right? Angle of attack became larger. Angle of attack actually increased because of the upwind. Does it make sense? So angle of attack has increased. What happened to U and W? Did they change? How do we define V and W? How did I define U, V, and W? They are the components of the velocity vector of the airplane with respect to Earth or inertial frame, if not otherwise defined. So if U, V, and W are the velocities of the airplane with respect to someone on Earth, it really didn't change. What has changed is V infinity. So they are the same because they are components of VE, and VE is the velocity of the airplane with respect to the guy on Earth. So that hasn't changed. But because of the upwind, the direction of V infinity has changed, and therefore alpha has changed. So far, so good? So far, so good. Okay. So alpha has increased. That means tangent alpha, you know, I had this story. This is no more accurate because this W belongs to the velocity of the airplane with respect to the guy from Earth, and this guy belongs also to the velocity with respect to the velocity with respect to someone on Earth. This doesn't take into account the wind. That's why I said this is true when there is no wind. When there is wind, although they are the same, their alpha has increased. So how would I make sure that this is here, that I get the right thing? Well, this would be okay if I would get the right components of the wind into the equation. And this is what I mean. We had this airplane. Okay. This was X body. And this was Y, Z body. Right? Now what you really need is, if this is my new V infinity, you need to decompose this V infinity into these two. Okay. Let's call this V infinity X and this one V infinity Z. So that would be equal to V infinity X and V infinity Z. What are they? What are they? V infinity X is equal to U, the velocity that we had previously, plus the component that is coming from the wind. The component that is coming from the wind. So you decompose this wind into this and that. So it would be this plus wind in the x direction, if you decompose it, and V infinity Z would be W plus the V infinity, the wind in the Z direction. Okay? Then you can do this. Then you can do this. So you have to include the alpha in these equations. When wind is zero, that means no wind, V infinity X is equal to U and V infinity Z is equal to W. Of course, in terms of magnitude, right? We are talking of magnitudes here. These are not vectors. I mean, talking about the magnitudes. The directions are kind of here. In this one? Yeah. Yes, thank you. So I think the confusion might come from the fact that the velocity of the airplane with respect to Earth and the velocity of the air particles moving to the airplane are two different things. So start from there if you get confused. Okay? Angle of attack and beta are at the end aerodynamic variables, aerodynamic angles. And they are defined by the movement of the air particles towards the airplane. We defined U, V, and W and the velocity of the airplane. We usually don't define them with respect to air particles. But the coordinate system, the wind fixed coordinate system, is therefore very valuable because it is a coordinate system that aligns itself with V infinity with respect to the air particles. That's why it is so valuable. For instance, in this case, XW would be in this direction, towards V infinity. It includes the wind. It includes the wind because it is aligning itself with the air particles. Okay? It aligns itself with air particles, and this V infinity must include the wind. But the movement of the airplane does not include the wind. Right? That was a trick I had a second ago. Look at this airplane. If I make this airplane move like that, what's the velocity of the airplane? It's this velocity, I mean, whatever you see. The velocity of the airplane is just this air velocity. If I don't give you the information there is wind from this side, you would think the airplane has zero side slip. Right? Because you don't know that there is wind. Once I give wind, you will say, oh, there is a beta. Why is there a beta? Because V infinity now points is not straight anymore. If there's a side wind, V infinity is here. Therefore, you have a beta. But the airplane is flying straight. Right? Flying straight. If there's no side wind, okay, if there's no wind, atmosphere is still, you're going like that, so this must be V infinity. Everybody understands that. Flying like this, this is V infinity, perfect. Okay? But if I tell you there's a side wind coming, not a side wind, but an upwind coming from below, then is this V infinity? No, it's this one. This plus this, this is V infinity. But if I don't tell you about the wind and you see this airplane, what would you say? If you don't know about the wind, you will say the velocity, the airplane has a velocity in this direction. It's straight. That's true. The velocity of the airplane with respect to u is actually this, and this is the velocity vector. But V infinity is not necessarily in this direction if there is wind. If there's no wind, yes, this is V infinity. But if there's wind coming from below, then V infinity suddenly is actually this. Although the airplane is flying straight, it has a large angle of attack because of the airplane or because of the air coming from below. And all I'm trying to do is really calculate this angle. That's alpha, right? So how am I doing this? I'm adding this velocity, the velocity of that airplane, plus the velocity of the air, and decompose it into x and y, and try to find angle of attack. That's what I did over here. Okay? I'm going really slow here. So we fully agree on this.
I'm confused about something. We have wind, and still, how do we go in this direction if we wind?
I don't care. The wind is blowing from below, and I'm going like this.
Right. The direction of the flight, doesn't it change? Because
well, if you're flying like this, suddenly there's a wind, it will start doing this. But the pilot can adjust the controls such that the airplane is still moving like this. You are always thinking, what will happen when this happens? What will happen? I'm just thinking always instantaneously. As an instant, the airplane might be flying like this and there might be a gust from here. What happens to the airplane after that is not really my concern, or that the alpha will simply change if it starts going up. If it starts going up with the wind, then your V infinity without the wind would be something like that. Plus the wind, maybe it's back here. Maybe this is your V infinity because you're going up and there's a side wind from below. So V infinity is maybe now this. But if you start going like that, the V infinity will be like that. Understand? Maybe the wind is coming from above. What will happen then? You're flying like that, wind is coming from above, V infinity is this. Do I have an alpha? Yes. Is it positive? It's negative, right? But the airplane is flying like that. So how do I calculate this alpha? I look at the velocity of the airplane, and I say the air particles, there will be air particles coming from the front because of this velocity, plus there is the wind, add them together, that's V infinity. And decompose it into X body and Y body, that's your alpha. If there's a side slip, take that V infinity, rotate around beta, and that's your alpha. Understood? If there's wind. Now, here's a cool thing. You see all these airplanes, when they land under crosswind, they land like this. You have probably seen the videos, right? With a certain angle. They don't go straight, but they go with an angle. Have you seen those videos? If you haven't seen them, go to YouTube and write crosswind landing. You'll see tons of videos. The airplane is going like this, and at the very last minute, it rotates and lands. You haven't seen these videos, right? What would you say the airplane, when it flies like that, what is the side slip here? And it says landing under crosswind, which means there's a crosswind. Crosswind means wind from the side. There's a wind from the side. And the airplane is actually flying like that. What is the side slip here? What? No side slip. It's funny, isn't it? Because you might think, because the airplane is flying like that, that it's flying under a large side slip. But if there's wind coming from the side, from that side, then if the airplane would be flying like this, this would have been side slip, because V infinity plus side wind, that would have been a side slip. But now that the airplane is flying with an angle like this, there is actually no side slip. But the airplane, when you look at it, looks like it's flying with an angle. It is flying with an angle with respect to you, not with respect to V infinity. So, the airplane, when there's crosswind, doesn't land like this. You have seen in videos, it lands like this. Why would it land like that? Why not like this? It reduces side slip and uses this and flies like that with zero side slip, by the way. And then at the very last moment, it rotates and lands like that. And when it rotates, now does it have side slip? Yes. At the very last moment, it does have side slip. But for a while, it doesn't fly with a side slip. Okay? Why would you do that? Why not do this? Well, first of all, there are two reasons. If you ask a pilot, a side wind will try to move the airplane this way, right? You fly like this, you get a side wind, and that's kind of dangerous. So what you want is you want to move towards the V infinity and fly like this. So there will be no velocity anymore that will make you roll. Okay? That's one reason. But another cool reason, another good reason, is because you want to make use of maximum V infinity during landing. Because V infinity means lift, right? V infinity squared gives you lift. So you don't want to do this. If you would be flying like this with an angle, you would be only using one component of V infinity to create lift. But now that you're using this, the wings get all the air that you want, right? And you get a lot of lift. You have V infinity coming from the nose. Okay? So you make use of all the air that is coming towards me. I'm moving my air towards my nose towards V infinity and get a lot of lift. That's why I would like to move my nose towards V infinity, and therefore side slip is zero or a small number. But I'm moving like that, and you might think, oh, the airplane is in trouble because it has a lot of side slip. In fact, it doesn't. The point when it does have a side slip is when it rotates. Now it has side slip. You see? Because you are moving forward and there's side wind, and yes, of course, you have side slip at the very last moment. So why doesn't the airplane land like this? Because the landing gear has to point in that direction, otherwise you break the landing gear, right? So at the very last minute, you land like this with zero, with a side slip you land. Understand? So look at these videos if you get confused with what I'm explaining to you. You look at the airplane moves with an angle like that. You might think, oh, there's a lot of side slip. In fact, there's not, because there's the wind. V infinity is here. The velocity vector of the airplane with respect to you is where? Is it here? No, it's here. Does it have a side velocity? Does it have a V, a UVW, you know, that small V? Does it have a small V? What is that small V? What is U? V and W. How do you define U, V, and W? It's the velocity of the airplane with respect to someone on Earth or the inertial frame, right? So, does it have a V velocity vector? V is in the body y direction. Does it have a side velocity? Yes, of course. How about the side velocity of the wind? The side velocity of the wind? No. Okay. So you might want to get one of these and play around at home and watch a lot of YouTube videos. Okay? Look at crosswind landing. I wanted to show you a few, but maybe next time. My laptop is out of battery right now. Okay? Look at crosswind landing. And try to talk about this and make some comments, okay? Or else I can quickly run to my room and get a charger. I think that would be a good idea, okay? So just wait 5 minutes and I run to my room and get a charger, okay? No, that wouldn't be very nice. So let's give a 5 minute break and I'll bring the okay, this is a video now on something, an airplane on crosswind. It's not the best picture, but now you can see, look at this very moment. It rotates and comes back, you see? Let's do it again. Comes in and at an angle, and you would think that the airplane has a large side slip, right? From which direction do you think the wind is coming? This way or that way? It's coming from here, right? So the nose is moving towards that wind, V infinity. What is side slip then? Zero, right? But it goes this way. Now, what about psi, the heading? If this was north, if the airplane landing strip was north, what would be psi? It would be this angle. It's almost at 40 degrees of a psi angle. And then it rotates the psi and looks towards north, if this was north. You know psi? Theta phi and psi, the Euler angles? Angle of attack? I don't know, there's some angle of attack. Side slip angle? Zero. If the landing strip looks towards north, there's certain psi. At the very ending, it will increase the side slip, but reduce the heading angle psi, and land. Look at that. You see? Rotating, rotating, rotating. Psi is back to zero, let's say, if this is in the north direction. And the side slip is now at a large angle when you rotate, you see? Let's look at another example. There are a bunch of airplanes. You see? And it actually rotates after it's done with its landing, you see? Nose down, and so on and so forth. I'm sure you can find better videos on YouTube. But these are some of the low resolutions that I have. Not so good of a video. Here's a big one. You might think that it comes in with a large side slip, you see? And the nose is pointing this way. So heading is something else, right? Heading is something else. Side slip is something totally different. The side slip might be zero here. The velocity vector of the airplane is actually towards you, right? But V infinity is actually towards the nose of the airplane. How come? This is the velocity vector of the airplane. So you have air particles coming from here, but you also have air particles coming from the side because of the wind, and V infinity is actually pointing this way. So side slip is zero, but the velocity vector of this airplane is towards you. I think that's a good example. And slowly it will turn now, turn. Now you have side slip and you land, and you're turning more after you land. You see? Does that make sense? Again, turning towards V infinity, rotating. What about side slip here? Angle of attack, I'm sorry. Let's go back here. Coming at an angle. At angle. And the moment you land, you kind of see the angle of attack. You see the angle of attack? It's not very big, but in this case, it is actually quite a number. You see? Here you can clearly see the angle of attack. If V infinity is coming from this way and V infinity is actually towards the nose, then this would be the angle of attack, right? Side slip zero. So if you rotate the nose back here, then the angle of attack will still be that, the projection of V infinity towards the local towards the symmetry plane. Rotate, angle of attack back to zero. Side slip, well, you're not in the air anymore, but typically you have a side wind at this point. So the airplane is really trying hard to stay on the ground so that it doesn't tip over. Because a strong side wind might actually tip over the airplane, right? So you don't want that. Okay, here's another interesting video I would like to show you. It's this one here. So, taking off, what do you think? Is this angle of attack? Not really, right? Because it is a little bit going up at the same time. We don't know. I mean, it might be going up like this, then angle of attack would be zero. Or it might be going like this, then angle of attack would be high. Or it could be a combination of them, a little bit angle, but at the same time going up a little bit. I think that's what's happening here. So V infinity might be actually coming somewhere here. So this would be alpha, but you might actually have also a large velocity going upwards. So up, take off. You surely have an angle of attack. What about now? Is this the angle of attack here? No. That would mean the airplane would fly like this, right? That would be the angle of attack. So that would be V infinity. But it's going up. So that the V infinity is coming now from towards the nose. And alpha is probably not that high still. Okay? So you have an airplane that is actually going up like that. It doesn't mean that this is V infinity, this is alpha. But what is this angle? What is this angle? That climb angle, we haven't heard anything of climb angle in this class. What is this angle? Huh? The pitch angle, and the symbol is? Theta, the pitch angle, okay? Airplane in this direction, body axis, okay? If this is north, let's say I'm just making this up, this is north, which way is psi? Start here, this would be the psi angle. This would be the theta angle, this would be the roll angle. So psi, theta, and phi, okay, if this was north. So that would be the angles for this airplane, psi, theta, and phi. How about angle of attack? Well, we don't know, it depends on V infinity, okay? How about the velocity of this airplane with respect to u? Well, I don't know, but it's going this way, so that's whatever that velocity you see, that's the velocity of the airplane with respect to u. Understood? Does it have side slip? Well, we don't know. If it's slipping to the side, it might. If there's a side wind, there might. I don't know. But the velocity of the airplane with respect to u is whatever you see it is. And it's back again. It has a certain roll angle now, you see? It's like this. So what are the Euler angles? Start, if this is north, this would be psi. Go up like that, theta, that's theta, and this is roll. Now you have that airplane. So at any moment you tell me theta, phi, and psi, I can tell you what the airplane is doing in space. What do I know about alpha and beta? Well, it depends on V infinity. V infinity is not only made up of the velocity of the airplane, but it also includes the atmosphere, the wind. So you tell me V infinity, I tell you what alpha and beta is. Okay? So I can't really see here if there's wind or not, but I can tell you the geometric Euler angles, and I can tell you the velocity I see of this airplane with respect to us. Okay, so that's that. So just give me one more minute, and then you're done. Just one more minute. If I have an airplane like that, okay, and this is X body, all right, and this is the ground. Basically, this is Earth, okay? Or I might also say this is XV, okay, the vehicle carrier coordinate system. So in that case, right, this one here, if there's no phi or anything in this picture, we call this usually, what angle is this? This is theta. We call it the pitch angle. Okay? Now, alpha depends on this one. This could be V infinity. So then this is alpha then. If V infinity comes from here. Is that okay? Is that fine? All right. So, never confuse this alpha with the theta. Another example. This is what you see in most books. This is airplane, this is that, this is X body, okay? And then you will see something like this. V infinity, okay? And then you will see this in the picture. This one will be your alpha. And then you will see this in the picture saying that this is your theta. Isn't it? Is it correct until now? Yes, it is correct, right? The angle. If there's, of course, no beta is equal to zero, phi is equal to zero, you know, this picture is a 2D picture. But you understand in 3D it will be kind of similar. So V infinity alpha beta. And then you will see in picture saying that this angle here is called the climb angle. Someone mentioned this. So climb angle would be theta minus alpha. So which means, why is this called climb angle? This is called climb angle. See, if climb angle was equal to zero, If climb angle was equal to zero, that would mean alpha is equal to theta, which means V infinity is going from here, right? That would be V infinity. If climb angle is equal to zero, that means alpha is equal to theta, and that would be the condition that corresponds to this. That would be V infinity. Alpha is equal to theta. Climb angle is equal to zero. So this would be V infinity. And if there's no wind, that would be the velocity of the airplane. Does the airplane climb? No. Therefore, whenever this angle is equal to zero, the airplane is not climbing. So therefore, this is called a climb angle. So whenever there's a gamma here, it means there's some sort of climbing in this airplane. For example, if gamma was equal to theta, which means alpha is equal to zero, look what the situation would look like. It would look like this. This would be theta, and that would be equal to gamma, and therefore this would be V infinity. Right? Is the airplane climbing if there's no wind? Of course, it is going up, because this would be the velocity of the airplane with respect to Earth, so it is climbing. If gamma is equal to zero, it's not climbing, it's going straight. If it's in between, it is climbing as much as there is gamma. So this is that. So I personally am not a favorite. Gamma is not my favorite angle, because it is confusing a lot of things. These 2D pictures explain everything very nicely, that's fine. But once you go into 3D, and V infinity is coming with a side slip and everything, it might get a little confusing. What you need to do is, if there's a beta angle, you take V infinity, move it towards the symmetry axis, and then you look at alpha, and then you look at gamma. But at the same time, if there's a phi, if you have an airplane with a phi that looks like this, where is theta? Well, you need to rotate this phi. Now this is theta. Now you need to do a few things to plot this picture. If there's a phi, you need to rotate phi and then plot theta. At the same time, you need to take V infinity, move towards beta and find alpha, and then talk about the climb angle. Right? So it is a bit confusing, because you're mixing now the angles that you got from the wind axis coordinate system and from the body axis to vehicle carried coordinate system, you know, those two angles. Note that the alpha and beta have something to do with aerodynamics, because they are related to V infinity. So it is totally related to the velocity of the air particles. So it's an aerodynamic angles, alpha and beta. Theta, phi, and psi, the Euler angles, are geometric angles. It has something to do where the nose is looking, what the angle of the airplane with respect to the Earth or your northeast down frame is. So there are geometric angles. Theta, phi, and psi, the Euler angles, are geometric angles. Alpha and beta, they are strictly related to V infinity, and therefore they are related to the air properties and therefore to aerodynamics. Understood? Okay. It's time for another homework. I will give you another homework this week. So next week you will hopefully do that homework. And then the following week we will have our midterm. Now, I will put an example midterm of past years onto the web, so you can kind of exercise. But don't memorize any questions. As I said, the midterm questions will be brand new, and I will create them. They don't exist anywhere. So I don't know what the questions are at this point, but I will try to be creative. If you do the homeworks correctly, if you understand everything, then you should be successful in the midterm as well. If you don't understand anything, go back to YouTube, because these lectures are now in YouTube. Okay? You can re-listen to the same lecture. All right, so see you next week.
Thank you.